everyone. We are discussing our 1.4 exercise, and in 1.4 we have completed second questions, first and second. Now we start with third question number 2, and it's third one. Okay, on Q you have to check AB equal to AB by 2. Okay, so what we have to check? First, you have to check is it a binary operation or not, and secondly you have to check commutative and associative or not. Okay, we have already discussed in our previous classes that how can you check for binary. It is given on Q. So if you have written numbers and you get answer in Q only, then it is binary. And for commutative, what is the rule? A and B and B and A, both answer is same. And for associative, A and B and C, that way you can choose this, right? So now both way we will prove it. First let's check for binary operation or not. So for binary operation we are choosing numbers in Q. So first easy number, 1 into 2 by 2, so you get 1. Now let's take one rational number, 1 by 2 and 1 by 3. So 1 by 2 into 1 by 3 by 2. 1 by 6 by 2 means 1 by 12. It is also in Q. What is the meaning of it? It is a binary operation. First binary proof. Now let's come to the commutative. What is the commutative? For that, easiest thing, we are choosing 2 and 3. Now we can write 2 into 3 by 2. So it is 3. Same way, 3 into 2 by 2. It is again 3. So from these two result you can say it is commutative. From the question only you recognize that if A and B related by AB by 2, then if you write B and A, then you can say BA by 2. Multiplication of A and B or B and A, meaning remains same because multiplication is commutative. So first part prove, it is a commutative and it is a binary also. Now let's come to the associative rule. Now in associative, what to do? A with B and C, and then you have to prove with AB and C. Okay, 2 and 3, 4 we are taking. So first let's multiply 3 and 4, 3 into 4 by 2. Now if you simplify it, 3 2s are 6. So what you get? 2 and 6. How can we write? 2 into 6 by 2 means answer is 6. Okay, now 2, 3 and 4. So 2 into 3 by 2 and 4. Again the same, 3 and 4. So 3 into 4 by 2. 2, 4 is that, and 3, 2 is that, 6. Here also you have 6th answer. Here also 6th means how we have proven commutative? It is associative also. So in this question we have checked all three things. It is a binary operation also, it is commutative also, and it is associative also. Okay, now let's come to the next question, fourth one. Now your fourth question is on Z plus given, and relation is given AB equal to 2 raised to AB. First let's check on Z plus given, means you have to choose positive number and you get answer also positive number only. Okay, let's start with 1 and 2. So A asterisk B is 2 raised to AB, means A is 1 and B is 2. So 1 into 2, 2 raised to 2 will be 4. Similarly, 1 and 3, so 2 raised to 1 into 3 means 2 raised to 3, 2 2 is the 4, 2 is the 8, and so on. So you get all the binary operations with Z plus only. So it is a binary. First part prove binary. Now what you have to check next? A commutative and associative. For commutative, we are taking AB and BA same. So 2 raised to AB, that is your term, and 2 raised to BA, meaning remain same, because if you multiply A with B or B with A, meaning is same. Okay, let's take one example, 2 and 3. So 2 raised to 2 into 3, so 2 raised to 6. Similarly, 2 on place of 3 asterisk 2. So 2 raised to 3 into 2, so 2 raised to 6, here also 2 raised to 6, here also you get 2 raised to 6, means it is a commutative, binary also, commutative also. Now let's come to the next part, associative. So we will check for associative. A with BC and AB with C. Okay, let's come to the first part with 3 and 4. Okay, 2 into 2 raised to 3 into 4. So 2 into 2 raised to 12. Now remember what to do. Here again, this as a A, this as a B. So 2 raised to 2 into 2 raised to 12. If you combine this power, then 2 raised to 2 raised to 13 you get. Similar way, let's check here, 2 and 3 and 4. So 2 raised to 2 into 3 into 4. Now 2 raised to 6 and 4. So 2 raised to 2 raised to 6 into 4 means 2 raised to 2 raised to 6, and this is 2 square, means 8. Here 13 power and here 8, so it is not associative, means it is a binary operation, it is a commutative but not associative. This is your question number 4. Now let's come to the fifth question. What is our fifth question? On R minus minus 1. What is defined? A asterisk B is A upon B plus 1. First we will check that, is it a binary or not? So first we check that, and then we will check that it is a commutative or associative. Okay, let's first R minus minus 1 given. SAT is given on R minus minus 1 means what? You can choose all the real number except minus 1. Means you cannot take minus 1, otherwise you can choose any number. Okay, let's come to the question. We are choosing 2 and 3. So 2 upon 3 plus 1. So 2 by 4, which is 1 by 2. Similarly, let's take 1 and 2. So 1 upon, see what you have to write first? A. And what is your B here? 2. So 2 plus 1, so 1 by 3, and that way what you get, it is all your real numbers. So from that you can say it is a binary operation. Okay, first part complete, that it is a binary. Now let's check it is a commutative or not. So we will start, A and B is A upon B plus 1. Now we are choosing 2 and 3. So 2 upon 3 plus 1, that is 2 by 4, so 1 by 2. Similarly, let's take 3 and 2. So 3 upon 2 plus 1. So 3 by 3 will be 1. Now check. Here one answer half we are getting, another answer is 1. So it is not commutative. If you get both the answers same, then only you can say it is a commutative. Now third one we have to check, associative or not. For associative, what you have to check? A and BC equal to AB with C, that way. Okay, so let's start with 2, 3, 4. So 2 and 3, 4. So first we get for 3 and 4, 3 upon 4 plus 1 means 2, 3 by 5. Again same, 2 upon 3 by 5 plus 1. So 2 upon, take LCM, 5 ones are 5 and 3, 8 by 5. So what you get? 10 by 8, or you can say 5 by 4. Now the same way, let's check the another thing. on the other side of it. What is it? A with B and C. Okay, 2 and 3 with 4. So 2 upon 3 plus 1 and 4, 2 by 4 and 4. So 1 by 2 and 4. What is it? 1 by 2 upon 4 plus 1. 4 plus 1 is 5 and 1 by 2 means 1 by 10. One answer you get 1 by 10. Another answer you get 5 by 4. Both answer are different, means it is not a associative also. Here we have proved it is not a commutative also, and here we have proved it is not a associative. Means it is a binary operation. Of course it is a binary operation, but it is not a commutative, not a associative. In all 5 questions of second question, we have derived that it is a binary or not, it is commutative or not, and it is associative or not. I think now commutative, associative, and what is the binary operation, that thing is more clear to you. Now we will start our next question, question number 3. Consider the binary operation. What is the binary operation is given on n? The set is given 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 and defined as A, B as a minimum of A comma B. Now you have to check for table. In SolSum I have already shown how to make a table for it, but then again one more time we will draw it for 1 to 5. Okay, what is the relation is given? This 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Similarly 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, now let's come to the table. We will draw the table for it. Remember, the condition is minimum among A and B. And how can you choose the numbers? First, we have to start with 1 and 1. So, minimum of 1 and 1 is 1 only. Minimum of 1 and 2 is again 1. Minimum of 1 and 3 is again 1. Minimum of 1 and 4 is again 1. Minimum of 1 and 5 is again 1. Now minimum of 2 and 1, that is also 1. 2 and 2, minimum is 2 only. 2 and 3, minimum is 2. 2 and 4, minimum is 2. And in 2 and 5 also, minimum 2. 3 and 1, then minimum number is 1. 3 and 2, minimum number is 2. 3 and 3, then 3 itself a minimum. 3 and 4 then 3 and 3 and 5 also 3. Now start with 4. 4 and 1 minimum is 1. 4 and 2 minimum is 2. 4 and 3 minimum is 3. 4 and 4 minimum is 4. And 4 and 5 also minimum is 4. And now 5 and 1 minimum is 1. 5 and 2, 5 and 3, 5 and 4 and 5 and 5. So this is called your table. Now the same thing we have already discussed with maximum also. Suppose on place of minimum, if you have given maximum, then how can you make? For maximum, this symbol we are using 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, now again the same procedure you have to repeat, but which number you are choosing? That should be maximum. 1 and 1, 1. 2 and 1, 2. 2 and 3, 3. 1 and 4, 4 and 1 and 5, then maximum is 5. Similarly, 2 and 1, maximum is 2. 2 and 2, maximum is 2. 2 and 3, maximum is 3. 2 and 4, maximum is 4. And 2 and 5, maximum is 5. Similarly, 3 and 1, 3 and 2, 3 and 3, 3 and 4 and 3 and 5. Similarly, 4 and 1, 4 and 2, 4 and 3, 4 and 4 and 4 and 5. Similarly, for 5, maximum number should be 5 only. So this table is for maximum and this one for minimum. That way, we are getting the both the tables for maximum also and for minimum also. Okay. Now let's start next question, question number 4. Read the question. Compute, consider a binary operation 1, 2, 3, 4, multiplication table of 1.2. Matlab, you have to choose the table. What is the table? Table number 1.2. 1.2 table is already given. So, I think that table we will draw it first and then we solve this question, which is already drawn in your book. But then again, once we draw it, question number 4, table is given, which is this, okay, for 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, similarly 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, numbers is 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, then 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, for 3, 1, 1, 3, 1, 1. Then 1, 2, 1, 4, 1 and last 1, 1, 1, 1 and 5. This way table is given. Now come to the first question. What is our first question? That compute 2, 3 and 4 and means you have to simply check the associative rule only. Okay, now let's start with this. 2, 3 and 4, first we find for 2 and 3, 2, we start with 2 and 3, so the number is 1, 1 and 4, okay, let's start with 1 and another is 4, so with 1 we start up to 4, so the number is again 1, clear? Now let's check that thing, 2 as it is 3 and 4. So, this is 3, start with 3 and 4, so 1. Now, 2 and 1, so 2 and 1, so number is again 1. So, first question clear, we have to find 2 asterisk 3 asterisk 4, same thing for the second also. Now, second, is it a commutative or not? For commutative, let's check for 2 and 3 only. What is 2 and 3? 1 and 3 and 2. Let's check 3 and 2. 3 and 2. It's again 1. So both answer is same. Therefore, it is commutative. This is your first question. This is your second question. It is commutative. Now, third question, compute 2 and 3 and 4 and 5. First 2 and 3. I rub this for second and then we start third one. Okay. In third one, 2 and 3 with 4 and 5. This is your question, right? 2 and 3, 4 and 5. Okay, let's start with 2 and 3. 2 and 3 here. So, answer is 1. Okay, 4 and 5. So, start with 4 and go to the 5. 5. So, this is your 1. Obvious 1 and 1. Here we have 1. Is it? So, this is your question number 3 and okay, only 3 questions are given. So, just check it once that when you draw this table, what you have to check 1 and 1, 2 and 2, that way all the numbers you can check and 2 related 3 given means you have to start with this 2 and go to the 3. So, when you get the combination of 2 and 3, that number should be written here. Similar way 4 and 5. So, here we have to start with 4, here we have to start with 5. So, 4 and 5, when they meet at 1. So, another answer also 1. Now, 1 and 1, relation of 1 and 1. So, this one, it meet again at 1. So, 1 into 1 also your 1. So, this is your question number 4. We complete up till question number 4 from the 5th question. We will continue in our next class. So, for today, thank you very much.